Hi, this is Gary with MacMost.com. MacMost is brought to you by the more than 300 people that support the MacMost Patreon campaign. You can find out more and become a part of it at MacMost.com/Patreon. So today we're going to take a look at something a little unusual. We're going to look at the accessibility keyboard and how we can use that to perform complex tasks that take multiple keystrokes. So the accessibility keyboard is something under System Preferences, Accessibility, and you go to Keyboard here and then Accessibility Keyboard. And you can enable it, and what you'll get is a keyboard that's on your screen, and you can type by actually clicking the keys on this virtual keyboard. Now, the real purpose of this is to be used with other hardware so that you can type if you're not able to use a regular keyboard. But an interesting feature of it is these are panels, and you can create panels. Actually, if you go to Panel Editor, you'll see that there's this panel, the regular ANSI keyboard panel, and also a numeric one as well. And you can add new ones. So we'll add a new one, and we'll call it My Shortcuts, and this is empty right here. We can actually add buttons to it. So we'll create a button here that does something specific. Let's call this button Test. We see we can edit the name here. And you get to do things like change the font size, position, and even include an image in it, a color, a spoken phrase that happens when you activate it. And an action. So the actions, this is what we're going to be looking at today. And there's a few things you can do in here, like you can trigger an Apple script. You can enter text. So I have like a phrase. It's kind of a similar thing to using some text replacement. You can open an app with one of these buttons. We're going to be looking at press keys, which allows you to give a series of key presses and repeat those by just clicking this button. So, for instance, if I wanted to go to the end of every line in a Pages document and add a period, I could do that if I were to do, let's say, Command, right arrow. So I just hit Command and right arrow, and you can see it entered it in there. Type the period, and then a forward arrow to go to the next line. So I'll stop recording here, and I'll call this button here Period at end. Now the next thing I want to do is I want to click here on the panels and go to My Shortcuts. See, I had to click away and click into it, and I get the panel controls here. So here I can select which apps to show this panel in automatically. I can change it to be as the home panel, which is what I'm going to do. So now it'll show up in place of this one. So now I'm going to do Save and enter yes, and I'm going to get a little panel here with my one button in it. So now let's try that out. Let's go into Pages here, and you can see this floats on top. I'm going to put the cursor here at the end of a line, and I'm going to hit period at end, and it should repeat those keys and go to the end of the line, enter a period, and then go forward one character to the next line. You can see that's what it does. And I can actually continue to press that, and you can see it adds a period at the end. I'm going to undo there. So that's one example. So here's another example, something that's almost impossible to do otherwise. I want to highlight or bold all of the words with the letter B in them. So in other words, find the text that has some text inside of it, select it, change it to bold, and be able to easily do it through the entire document. Now normally that would be difficult. I can't find and replace. I don't want to just bold that letter. I want to bold the entire word containing that letter. So first thing is to figure out a key sequence. So a good key sequence here is Command F and then type the letter B. By the way, I would make sure that you have whole words turned off so it's looking for that letter. And once you've typed the letter B, the next thing I'm going to do is return. And you can see it goes to the next selection there. That's fine. Then I want to close this window, and the way you close windows on the keyboard is Command W. I want to stick to just keyboard commands while doing this. So now I've got a word, a letter and a word selected. So how can I select the entire word? It's tricky, but you can use the Option key to do it. And one thing that works in all cases, no matter if it's the first letter, last letter, or middle letter, is to use the right arrow, to go forward one, then the Option left arrow to go to the beginning of the word, and then Shift Option right to select the entire word. Now that it's selected, I can do Command B for bolding. Now, if I leave it there, the next time I run this, it's going to find that same B. So I'm going to do right arrow once to go to the end of the word. So the next time I use the button, it finds the next one. So now that I've got that sequence down, let me undo and let's go back to the panel editor and add this as a button. So I add a button. We'll position it where we want there. We'll do words with B as the name. And the action will be press keys. So we have to remember the sequence now. The sequence was Command F for find. Oh, sorry, I have to record. Command F for find. Then B to find, B return. Then Command W to close that window. Now it should have that letter selected. So now we want to do the forward arrow, Option left to go to the beginning of the word, Shift Option right to select the entire word, and Command B to bold it, and one more forward arrow just to go to the end of that word. So I'll stop recording. I've got this here. Let me go and save this. And we'll update that panel. And let's switch to our Pages document. I'll go to the beginning there and I'll hit Words with B. And you can see it did it for the word by. Let's do it again. Best, billows, bright, because. Excellent. So I can just continue to press this button a bunch of times and it will work. So one of the things you can do so you don't have to keep clicking the button is you can turn this option on, treat as a sticky key. So repeat until activated again. So you click it once, it keeps repeating, and then you click it again to stop. But in practice, for things like this, it's kind of clunky because it kind of gets ahead of itself. There's a bunch of times it's issued those commands and you try to turn it off and it's still going. Experiment with that one and see if it's useful in situations like this. Thank you.